first time we met was through our friend Tiff. So she's like, I was single, right, doing my thing. And then she said, oh, I have a perfect match for you.
I was with my mom paying a bill in Macy's, and she said, oh, I told him to call you.
So Tiff told me that she was gonna be at Renee's house, so it wasn't like awkward. And then I brought up my friend, Evan, and then we just went up for some beers and just got to know Renee, right? And, you know, when I got there, I mean, she was all boss, you know? She's walking around in a boot and crutches and...
I was actually all bus up. Like, I had a boot and I had crutches.
For me, it didn't really matter, you know? I was there to actually get to know her, so I'm not gonna judge her based on her handicap, right? Taste in my mouth, girl, you're the only one that I want. Wanna be your ride.
It was March of 2014 when my brother had come home from this restaurant in Manoa, Tokunami. And he had told me, he goes, oh, guess who I saw? And I was like, oh, who? And then he's like, oh, Ricky. And I was like, really? And he goes, yeah. He goes, you know, he's actually looking really good. And he's, you know, he's all cut up, he's working out. And I was like, yeah, right, no way, right? Yeah, and he shaved off his Fu Manchu thing because he had this whole like gold tee going on.
Oh, why she brought that up?
Right here, like on his chin, and it like hung all the way down to like right here. So if you can imagine, you know, it was just like this strays of these hairs, just like a patch of hair right here.
Well, the facial hair was, I mean, it was, It was kind of long. It was just down here, long. I was actually kind of proud of it, but she didn't like that too much.
I was like, okay, I'm gonna add him on Instagram, and so I added him on Instagram, and after that, then he texts me, and he goes, "Do you know who Panty Droppa is?" And that was his IG name at the time, right? And so...
I guess she like stalks me on Instagram, right? She adds me on Instagram, and then I'm like, doi 53. Okay, I know who this is. So I accept, and then I message her, and I'm like, do you know who the Panty Droppa is? Like, that's like the first thing that I said to her when we first touched face the second time. And I'm like, do you know who the Panty Droppa is? And then, you know, we just started talking, and I mean, to make a long story short, she just like stole me away from the girls that I was talking to. I guess, girls, you know?
And then we started talking again and hanging out. And from that point forward,
she asked me, like within the first week, she's like, if you're serious about this relationship, you'll start a wedding fund. And I'm like, it's 1 week, and she's already thinking about wedding. Either she really loves me or she's crazy.
Ricky may actually be very rough and tough on the outside, but on the inside, he actually has the biggest heart I know, and I would say out of all the men I know, I've seen him cry the most, you know, and it really, when he's talking about friends and family, you know, they mean the world to him, and that's what I saw in him.
Pretty much same values, you know, and what I see and feel is important, she does too, you know. Family is important, friends are important, you know. Important to make sure that you work and where she sees herself down the road, I can see myself too, so it works out, you know, it works out for us. But plus she's kind of cute, you know. Only one that I wanna be around. Wanna be around her. Wanna be around, girl. Ooh, wanna be around, girl.
Ricky, I want you to know that even though I do give you a hard time and I know that I'm not easy, I do love you a lot, and I thank you for doing everything that you do for me and my family, and I can't wait to spend the rest of my life with you, and I can't wait to see what the future has to hold for both of us. I love you.
Just want you to know that I really love you, even though at times, you know, it doesn't seem like it, but I really do. And I mean, cry a little bit, but that's love though, you know. And thanks for putting up with my shit, but at the same time, you're welcome for me putting up with yours. And everything you do for me, I really appreciate it. And I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for you. So thank you for the opportunity. I really love you.